1, 2, 3, start. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Frugal Green Indian Blogger channel. Wow, that's a mouthful. Okay, so if before you start watching this video, if you haven't seen the previous video, the part 1 of the IELTS writing, how you can write better, how you can write yourself from a 5.5 to the desirable 7 band, then please go and check out that video. Link should be somewhere there, or it's there in the description box as well. Okay, all right, now that you have watched that video and you have understood about simple sentences, compound sentences and complex sentences, now what should we do? Don't you think we should learn about sentence starters? Different types of sentences, okay, but how are you actually going to start your sentences? So this video is going to be about that. Okay, now the key things you need to remember before you start sentences is that your sentence starter should have a subject. In subject, by subject I mean not the things which you learn, those, not those kind of subjects, but actually nouns. Okay, the main person or the main thing or the main animal or the main insect, the main person or the main subject you're talking about, the sentence is going to talk about. Okay, and it should also have a verb. Now by verb I mean an action word, a word which is showing some sort of an activity. Okay, now how does that look like? That you have seen some simple, very simple examples of how a sentence should actually start off with a subject and a verb. Now let's see the simple or the common mistakes which we tend to make when we're trying to form all those complex and all those compound type of sentences. Okay, so I gave you 3 sentences. I have it on my laptop and I'll just read those out. Sam was given an opportunity by his university to study abroad in Italy for 6 months. Okay, now here the main person we are talking about is obviously Sam, and what is he doing? He has been given an opportunity by his university. The key word here is university has given him that opportunity to study where? In Italy. Now when you read this first sentence, it does look like it's not a simple sentence, it's a complex type of sentence. Yes, very good, we have been successful in forming a well elaborated sentence rather than just sticking to just a simple sentence. Good, but can you understand what is the mistake here? I'll put the sentence again. Let's just have a look. Wonderful. Now the key here is, yes indeed, Sam is the main person, but more than the main person, or more than talking about Sam, the main thing here is that the university has given him an opportunity. Okay, Sam has been given this opportunity by his university. That is the main idea that we are trying to project through this sentence. We're not trying to tell about Sam and that he goes to university, that he will be going to Italy. No, the main thing is that Sam has been given this opportunity rather than someone else, right? So let's correct the sentence and make it better, more precise, and still maintain the complexity of the sentence. As you can see here, I've written, Sam's university gave him an opportunity to study abroad in Italy for 6 months. Okay? Our main subject, Sam, and the university. Here there are 2 main subjects, Sam and his university. And what has been done? He's been given an opportunity to study abroad. Okay? To study abroad. Given, gave him. So gave is our action word. Sam's university are our subjects. Okay? Now let's see the next example. Seema's bicycle was stolen near the mall. Okay, this is our next sentence. Seema's bicycle was stolen near the mall. Okay, so in this case, you'll say that both the subjects are there in the beginning, Seema and her bicycle. And the key, the action word here is stolen. And where was it stolen? Near the mall. Okay, so all the things are here. Then what is wrong with this sentence? Pause the video and look at the sentence again. Right. Did you understand what's wrong with the sentence? Do you really think that Seema's bicycle should be the main focal point here? Yes, that was stolen. The bicycle was stolen. But do we understand what the sentence is trying to say? Are you trying to say that Seema's bicycle was stolen? Or are you trying to make the reader or make the examiner understand that you're not sure that her bicycle was stolen by whom? Okay? Think about that and then see how I have corrected the sentence. Someone stole Seema's bicycle near the mall. I'll repeat it again. Someone stole Seema's bicycle near the mall. Okay? Now let's analyze why this sentence is better than the previous sentence. In the previous sentence, we understand that Seema's bicycle was stolen. That's it. It's not giving any hint as to what or who must have stolen it. Or it's not even giving us a direction to where this story is going. You're just breaking the sentence and you're just stating a fact. Seema's bicycle was stolen near the mall. You're not leading to a sentence. You're not helping yourself to build a story around the sentence. Okay? Yes, you are able to make simple sentences and convert it to complex and compound sentences. But you have to remember that in IELTS or any type of essay writing or letter writing activity or any type of creative writing which you're doing, a sentence should lead up to a story. You should help yourself to create such sentences that you are leading up to a story. You're weaving a story, okay? In a story, sentences don't just sit there by themselves. It's always moving on to a further story, okay? So that is why it makes more sense to say someone stole Seema's bicycle near the mall. Now what will happen is when you use this line instead of the previous line in your essay writing or even in your letter writing, you can build up on this. Okay? Again, yes, our subject shifts. Rather than making just Seema and her bicycle as the focal point, we are adding a new subject, someone. Now who's that someone? What is he? Who is he? What is she? What does she do? What does he do? You can just build up on that and create an entire story behind it. Okay? Let's move on to the third sentence. When he realized not much work was being done by students in the course was completely redesigned by Dr. Watt. Okay, I'll read the sentence out loud again. When he realized not much work was being done by students in the course, comma, the course was completely redesigned by Dr. Watt. Now let's analyze this again. Okay, there's someone called as Dr. Watt and he's made a course, but he's realizing that students are actually not putting in much effort or not much work in behind it. So he has to completely redesign the course. Why? Because he wants the students to learn better. He wants to teach the students better about the course. Okay? Now, who is our main subject here? You're right. Dr. Watt is our main subject here. Okay? It's not the course. It's not even the students. Students, course, these are all nouns. Same as Dr. Watt. But the main person or the main subject here is Dr. Watt. And the main action is that realization is the action, and of course later on the redesigning of the course. That's the main activity. First main activity is the realization, right? It's not the redesigning which is the main activity. The realization is the main activity. Dr. Watt has to realize first that students are not doing much work. So this is how you can reframe it and make it even better, make it even stronger. When Dr. Watt realized students were not doing much work in the course, he completely redesigned it. I'll repeat it again. When Dr. Watt realized students were not doing much work in the course, he completely redesigned it. Okay? Good. So you can't just keep on using complex and compound sentences in your essay or in your writing. You have to vary it. Okay? Yes, indeed, complex and compound sentences are those big ticket thing. Okay? But you need to put in some simple sentences as well. Vary the sentence length for appropriate pace and flow. For appropriate pace and flow. Okay? You can't just be running with your story. You need to pace it out to build the story better, to build the interest of the reader. Okay? Next very important key point is start sentences with a subject and action verb. I'll repeat it again. You have to identify who should be your main subject and what should be your main action verb. Okay? Next is place words of emphasis at the end of a sentence. Why do you think I've written that? Place words of emphasis at the end of a sentence. Place words of emphasis at the end of a sentence. Okay. And the next thing is allow punctuation to set the pace. I talk about the last thing about punctuations and why punctuations are important. And by the way, that will be in our next video. Why punctuations are so important. Let's finish today's part 2 by understanding what do I mean by words of emphasis. Okay. Let's go back to that sentence about Dr. Watt. When I reframe the sentence, I have written, when Dr. Watt realized students were not doing much work in the course, he completely redesigned it. Okay? Yes, we are following the second key point. We are placing our subject and action word. Subject is Dr. Watt and realization is the main action word in the beginning of the sentence. But what's making it more impactful other than this trick is that he completely redesigned it, and instead of putting it in the beginning, I have kept it and I've maintained it by putting it at the end. The end is redesigning. So when the person who's reading a sentence leaves the sentence, he or she will understand, okay, so the Dr. Watt has taken a lot of effort to redesign the course. And why do you think he's redesigned it? So that it's easier and better and good for the students to follow the course. He wants the students to do more work. He wants the students to learn better. That's why he's redesigned it. You can build up on that. So when your reader is leaving that story, he's leaving with that notion. Okay, so redesigning is done. Now what? The now what question. What? Why? How? Okay? The what is that He's redesigned it. Now you can build up and you can maintain that flow. Why did he redesign it? How did he redesign it? Build up a story on that. Okay? So it is absolutely important to leave those impactful and emphasis words at the end to maintain that continuity, to maintain that interest of your reader. I'm leaving you with a few more examples, and after that will be your assignment questions. Okay? I am still waiting on people to send me their assignment answers from part 1. If you haven't done so, please do. I've also added my Instagram link for you all to message me or just leave me your question or leave me your assignments as well. Here are some examples of what I mean by all these key points put together. And here are your assignment questions. Please leave the assignment answers in the comment down below. Okay? How am I gonna help you if you don't help me back? Perfect. Now remember, go through part 1 and part 2. It is a chronological series. If you do not do part 1, you cannot understand part 2. Okay? Similarly, when I make the part 3 on the importance of punctuation, if you haven't gone through part 1 and part 2, it doesn't make sense. I'm trying to make it in an order so that it's easier for you to grow in your writing. Okay? Till then, take care. I'm waiting for your assignment results and assignment work. And stay safe.